the Techipedia. Hit on the subscribe button, hit the notification bell icon, and you can enjoy weekly techie videos.
So, as we all know that to play PUBG on PC is not a free of cost, but today we'll be doing so. So, welcome guys, it's me Devbarbo, and for this thing, what you need to do is basically just go to the website that I went to, download that setup, and you'll be getting the link in the description box below. It's basically the official PUBG link. Basically, it's an emulator Tencent gaming buddy, as you can see. So it's a basically an emulator which will emulate the game, and you will be able to play PUBG. It's not like those other Android emulators. This emulator will be particularly based on enhancing your PUBG experience. Now this will be installing the PUBG Mobile. I guess it will be of 3 gigabytes, or it will be taking up 3 gigabytes of space. And so firstly you have to just download it, then it will be installing. I'm just skipping the parts because it will be too much tough time consuming. At the side you can just see, you can go through the controls, and definitely you can change your keyboard mappings, and it will be quite simple. So it's quite simple to play PUBG on your PC without any other Android emulator, and without going through the main procedure of downloading and paying and downloading through Steam, which is the original one. Rather, you can just play this one and you'll be getting similar kind of experience of which you had on the Steam one. And signing in through the guest, because the Facebook one is already signed in through my mobile. Now another thing is that while you're signing in, you won't be playing with other players who are playing through the mobile. Basically you'll be playing against players who are using the same emulator. So definitely you'll be again having to customize your character and create it. Then what you have to do is just simply, you all know, give it a name and just go. There you go, and it will be having those basic updates which you have in your Play Store. Similarly, it will be just updating the game. So, and it won't be that difficult when you are aiming. I thought so, it will be a very difficult task to aim or picking up objects, but when you get used to it's quite similar like the other shooting games, and the controls will be quite similar like the basic PC version. So I'm just starting the classic, and it will be a squad mode, so we are getting that Miramar map too, but I'm not going to the Miramar map. Another thing is that the gameplay will be definitely of the mobile, so you won't be expecting the gameplay of the PC which you get with the high graphics. The thing is that it will be the graphics set by the game defaultly will be of what the system thinks. Definitely the UHD system is still not available, so you can definitely go for the high quality. And if you have that graphics card, it definitely requires a minimum of 4 gigabytes of RAM to get running, and I guess a little hefty processor would be doing your job. So as you can see, also you have that microphone option with which you can speak with any of the members. It's not just basically your team members. So the gameplay remains the same as I previously told, just like the mobile, and it's quite simple. Just press F to jump. Let's just jump. I'll be skipping the gameplay part again, and I'll be just showing you the basic aiming practices and other stuff. I don't know whether it uses bots or not, but it's quite fun to play when you are out of your mobile and just play it on your PC without buying it. I hope you like this video. Do not forget to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, hit that bell icon, and I hope to meet you in our next video. Still lagging in reaching the 1,000 subscribers, and we'll be hoping that this video will make up. Peace out.